You can start.
ओम धन्वंतरे नमः ज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. ए वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स. Myself, Dr. Anu Krishna, second year PG scholar from Advaita batch, Department of PG Studies in Kai Chikitsa, TGMC, Ballari. Taranath Government Ayurvedic Medical College and Hospital welcomes you all to Dr. M. Ishwar Reddy Memorial Kai Chikitsa Webinar Series 2021 on Chronic Kidney Disease in the memory of late Dr. G. Srinivas Acharya sir. We Taranath Government Ayurvedic Medical College and Hospital are blessed with Swargiya Pandit Sri Taranath Ji's name. Chronic kidney disease is a burning topic in the market. So on the occasion of World Kidney Day, we decided to conduct a webinar series on CKD, containing four sessions from March 10 to March 12, covering modern and Ayurvedic aspects of CKD. So now this is the third session of our webinar series. It's my privilege to introduce today's guest speaker, Dr. Jitesh M.K. This Ayurveda physician of Kottakkal Arya Vaidyashala completed his Ayurveda graduation from Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences and completed his postgraduate studies in Rasa Shastra and Vaishishya Kalpana in the same university. Dr. Jitesh has not only a clinical experience to his credit, but also adequate experience in his practical as well as pharmaceutical aspects. He is renowned for his interest in academics and has handled classes ranging from national to international level in the field of Rasa Shastra. He has few articles published in reputed peer-reviewed journals as well. We are very happy to have you here, sir, for today's first lecture. Now I request our HOD, Dr. Madhav Digavi sir, for welcoming our guest speaker.
Hello. Good evening, sir.
Namaste, sir. Good evening, sir. Namaste, sir.
I'm very glad to meet you, sir. Today.
Thank you.
Today we are having another important webinar session from Dr. Jitesh M.K. sir from Kerala. We are fortunate that on the event of World Kidney Day, a meaningful celebration is going on. This is third among the series. Yesterday we have started with a nephrologist talk on CKD perspective in clinical practice. In the afternoon we have discussed about Ayurveda and CKD understanding by Dr. Prasanna Moksali. Now, an eminent speaker, Dr. Jitesh Jain, is amongst us on behalf of Taranath Government Ayurvedic College and Department of PG Studies in Kai Chikitsa. I welcome you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
And we are eager to hear to you for, in the respect of CKD and clinical practice, medicines, and Aushadhi Kalpana, Aushadhi Yojana. With this, without taking much of the time, I welcome Dr. Jitesh for current webinar.
Once again, thank you, sir. First of all, yeah, let me thank the organizers of such a great event, especially Dr. Sri Ganesh, Dr. Pooja, and Dr. Anukrishna, and the great Madhav Digavi sir and the principal madam. I'm really honored to get a chance in such a institution with this much great lineage. Really, I'm becoming more honored as well as I'm becoming humbled. And there is one more speciality is that even though Dr. Ajay Srinivasa Acharya sir didn't, I'm not his direct disciple, but there is a fact that I started treating kidney diseases, what we say, after listening to one of his great lecture. We in our institution called him for a national seminar in the year of 2015. Up to that time, really, even though I started my career in the year of 2005, I didn't handle our, I was referring even if some renal patients are coming to me. I was not knowing that this much easy or this can be managed through Ayurveda. I didn't have that confidence. But really, after listening to his lecture in 2015 October, it was in 2015 October, I still remember. And it was an eye opener. And that lecturer that made me to gain more confidence in treating such diseases. After that, I started working on this topic and later feel that Ayurveda is the best one in managing such diseases. So once again, I am thanking you all for giving me such a wonderful opportunity. So shall we go to the slides, sir? Can I?
Yes, sir. Excuse me? We can start, sir. Yes.
Yeah. Slide.
Yes, sir.
So, yeah. Actually, I wonder, is there a term or is there a chapter called chronic kidney, the previous one, the first one. Sorry, the second one. The second one, yeah. Next. This is what I wonder, actually. Is there a chapter named chronic kidney disease in any of our Samhitas? No. Definitely, there is no such a chapter called kidney disease or definitely in Vaishyajaranavali, there is one Vrikaroga Adhigara is there, but still, we cannot find an exact correlation with a chronic kidney disease in such in that chapter also. So, how to treat an Anukta Vyadhi? That is the most important hurdle in front of us while treating the disease. If it is a Vata Shonida, I feel more easy. If it is a Prameha, I feel more easy. But in these kind of diseases, like chronic kidney diseases, etc., comes under Anukta Vyadhi. So it's really important to handle such diseases which are not mentioned in our classics. How can we do that? Next. There is a quotation in Sushruta Samhita that is Nasti Rogo Vina Dosher or Anuktam Abhi Doshanam Linger Vyadhi Mubajaret. Anuktam Abhi Doshanam Linger Vyadhi Mubajaret. This indicates the importance and the method. This points to the method of dealing Anukta Vyadhi or the disease which doesn't have direct reference in our system. So, the only method to understand Anukta Vyadhi or the only method to treat this type of Anukta Vyadhi is nothing but going deep to the doshic permutations and combinations, the doshic vitiation, the dhadu vitiation, etc. And that points this line, this end, this only line is only sufficient to deal with the to handle successfully the anukta vyadhi. That is anuktam api doshana lingir vyadhim samupajare. Next. So actually today I am supposed to talk about management principles and aushadha yojana, or the wiseful selection, the logical selection of medicines. So for that purpose, I just need I cannot directly start from the medicine for making my theories my perceptions more clear. I just need to rewind, or I just need to go to the nidana part little bit, and without nidana we cannot explain the chikitsa. And for understanding nidana, definitely the sharira rachana and sharira kriyas it's an essential part. So with the back support of kriya sharira, rachana sharira, nidana, and we will start to the topics clearly. So for that purpose we need to know what is vrikka, what is kala, what is dhatu, what is kleda. These three are the important factors which take part in the samprapti of manifestation of vrikka roga, especially this type of chronic kidney diseases. So why or how these structures are important, that we will see. Yeah, next one. How the vrikka is being formed, we know it's been explained in the chapter Angavibhagam chapter of Sharira Sanashtanga there. That is shonida medha sambhudam. That is initially there will be kleda, and from kleda there will be the formation of kala, and from kala there will be the medodhara kala, and from medodhara kala, by the predominance of medhas and rakta, there will be the formation of vrikka. This is what explained the details regarding the formation of vrikka. And just these points are quite needed for explaining the treatment principles. That's why I'm going little bit deep into the sharira. Next one. So the first step to understanding the treatment principles, the first one is, the first important basic principles what we need to know is kleda. We should be quite thorough regarding the what is kleda, or what is meant by the term kleda. What I feel is kleda is the representation of jaliya bhava of panchamahabhuta to panchabhautika twin body. We know our body is made up of panchabhautika, isn't it? The tasya purushasya prithvi murti apa kleda tejo abhisantava is mentioned in the sharira sthana. So apa kleda, so the jaliya bhava, the ambu bhava, which represents the representation of ambu bhava in the body, can be called as the kleda. There is no clear cut, we cannot find a clear cut definition what is kleda in anywhere in the samhita. So we have to randomly collect the, or we have to gather the various information, the informations from different parts of the text. In some other areas, it is being called as the snehamsa, or the pool of sneha of the body. And it is more related to kapha, and up to some extent pitta also. Snehanam, we know that snehanam vishyandam kleda karakam. These are the function of sneha dravya, that is which causes vishyanda, and that which produce kleda karaka is sneha. Many of times we have got a false belief that kleda is something should be expelled from the body. Such a many classes or many articles I have read that the kleda is something, it's almost, so many of us consider this kleda as a waste product like mutra or purisha. But definitely kleda is not a malaruba, and but the kleda is the one which is needed in our body. That it's a physiological part for the maintenance of the proper stability of the body. Next. Yeah. So the drava bhava, we can see, as I mentioned that, what we say, kleda is the, in the previous slides I have mentioned that kleda is the jaliya bhava or drava bhava of kleda. Now the representation of body. So what is drava bhava? Again, for that purpose, we have to go to sharira sthana once again. The drava bhava is nothing but dravastu yat adiyogena chavamanam purisham anubadhyati. Adiyoge, it's very important. What is, first we have to understand what is dravam. Then only we can go to the nidana part. Well, so adiyogena chavamanam purisham anubadhyati. Tata mutra rudhira anyascha dhadun. It's just like it's a part which is being produced due to the dhadu formation, or which is, it's a byproduct of dhadu formation. That's what explain adiyogena chavamanam purisham anubadhnadi, along with the purisha, with the form, at the time of formation of purisha, the drava bhava is also is being generated. And the another one is very important, tatha mutram rudhiram anyascha dhadun. All the other dhadus are also, have also got this drava bhava. Next line is sarva sharira gatam bahyatvam bibharti, and that is that again he explained what I explained as, which is sarva sharira gata, and especially that is being, that is situated over the bahyatvam. That's why sveda vahanam srodasam, what is that, yeah, the kleda is the sveda se kleda vidhruti. The kleda dharana is the function of sveda. Tugandare vranagadam lesiga shabdavachyam. So the lesiga, which is being situated in between the different layers of tuk, is also called as drava bhava. It's also one among drava bhava. Yachya tugandaram vranagadam lesiga shabdavachyam. Next one is sveda vachyam cha. Ursum ushmana pakvam sveda vachyam cha. So these are the various drava bhavas of our body. That is, one is purisham anubadhyadi mutram rudhiram anyascha dhadun. That is the first one. Second one is sarva shariragadam bahyastuk vivarti. The one which is situated over the all over body and situated around above the tuk. And the next one is in the, which is being situated in between the layers. Tukandari pranagadam lasiga shabdavachin. That can be, the lasiga also can be called as drava bhava. And the next one is chavamanodbaddham roma gubebhyam abhinishpam sveda vachyam. That also, the which is being produced, which is being expelled through the roma kuba, that is sveda. So these are the various drava bhavas of the body. Next one. See, the kledam, as I explained, this is what I explained in the previous stage. Many of us consider kledam as a material which should be expelled always. Wherever there is kledam, that should be expelled. But such a, if we have got such a concept, that's quite wrong. That's what I wanted to point. Kledam, there are three aspects of kledam mainly. One is kledam is, it's a physiological one, and the next one, it is pathological one, and the third one is therapeutically induced one. Which are they? We will try to find out. The physiological one, where we can find out the physiological mentioning of kleda. Yeah, anyone? Ushma pachati. That the first reference we can get from the ahara parinamagara bhavas. Ushma pachati, vayur apakarshati, sneho mardavam janedi, kledo shaithilyam apadayati. So the kleda is the one, the essential part of digestive system. That is the one reference. Ushma pachati, vayur apakarshati, sneho mardavam janedi, kleda shaithilyam apadayati. The one which disintegrates the samhata, the compactness of food, is nothing but kleda. So kleda is an essential part for the purpose of the proper digestion. Next one is, during the digestion also we can find out the different references. Annam adana karmatu prana koshtam prakarshati. Tad dravet bhinna sankhadam snehena mududam gadam. Tad dravet bhinna sankhadam is nothing but kleda saithilyam apadayati. The first one was the reference from Ashtanga Sangraha, and the next one was the reference from Charaka Samhita. tad dravair bhinna sanghadam snehena mrududangadam. This dravair bhinna sanghadam is further explained by jalpagalpataru, that is Acharya Gangadhara, as kledaga sleshma bhava. What is kleda? What is the kledaga tapa? Amashesthidu anna sanghadasya kledanan kledaga. So anna sanghadasya kledanam is the function of kledaga kapha, and that is the foremost one, that is the most important one which takes part in the process of digestion. This is the physiological aspect of kleda. Now what is let's go to the pathological. And at the same time, as I explained, kleda is more related to kapha as well as pitta. When we go to the prakrita karma of pitta, definitely we can find the reference in doshadi vijnaniya, that is sveda kleda shruti kodha sadana murcha. Sveda kleda shruti kodha sadana murcha, that is been explained like that. And this kleda is one, the second one is explained as the prakrita karma of pitta. And the next one is very important, that is kodha. Kodha is being explained by Hemadri as adishayena kleda, that or adhikyena kleda is nothing but kodha. So there comes the physiological, the prakrita karma of pitta, and at the same time being its jaliya bhava, is related to kapha also. Now let's see to the pathology. In each and every dhadu, the pathological the kleda is the previous one. The pathological aspect of kleda we can find out in each and every dhatu. See, the first, we can just take the example of prameha. Vasti masrita nidana, let's go to the nidana of prameha. Sampraptiyo from vasti masrita kurite pramehan dushita tapha dushayitva vapu kleda sveda medo rasamishan. Vasti masrita kurite pramehan dushita tapha dushayitva vapu kleda sveda medo rasamishan. The first one. Now we will see each and every dhadu, what could be the role of kleda. In rasagada, we can find, we can consider this pandu as a rasagada kleda, and rekta, the various types of pushta as well as visarpa. Visarpa in the context of visarpa is typically explained when Acharya explained the importance of rektamoshna, that is chakha dushte durudiri rektameva adito hare. Tvang mamsa snayu sankleda rekta kleda adhijayate. The kleda, the tvang mamsa snayu sankleda rekta kleda adhijayate is produced due to the kleda of rekta and the visarpa. And the mamsa also, it comes with the visarpa, can be considered as the kleda situated in the mamsa. In the medas, if kleda is situated, that leads to prameha. In majja, if the kleda is situated, that is leads to vitrati, especially majja paripaka vitrati. Like that, in pushta, see the importance of kleda in pushta, that is prabadhya dhadun vyapyanda sarvan samkledya chavahe asveda kleda samkothan krimin sushman sudharunan. Asveda kleda samkothan krimin sushman sudharunan is the pathological process or the pathological progress of pushta. So there also kleda becomes an important pathology. And now the another one, that is ashmari. Now we will see whether ashmari is related or not. So all these factors, that is pandu, prameha, pushta, and everywhere there is the increase of kleda. It's being produced due to the increase of kleda. At the same time, the decrease of kleda also produced some of the disease. Ashmari becomes an example for that. Yada vayur mukham vaste avrutya parishoshaye, the shoshana is becomes the reason here. Mutram sabittam sakapam sa shukram vatada kramat. Yada vayur mukham vaste avrutya parishoshaye, the avarana and shoshana of mutra, pitta and kapha leads to the formation of sajayade asmari ghora pitta gorivarojana. That's what explains the context of ashmari. So here ashmari becomes an important disease which is produced due to the decrease of kleda. Especially we say the gallbladder calculi, the cholelithiasis, we can correlate as the reduction in the kleda. See, the reason for the formation of gallbladder stone is nothing but reduction in the content of bile salt. And once the quantity of bile salt has been reduced, there will be that is salt, that is lavana. There will be the lack of lavana, and when that lavana is reduced, the kleda will be reduced, and there will be the increase of vata, and thereby the bile becomes solidified and becomes as a stone formed. So this is from this, both the increase and decrease of kleda becomes a pathology. There, the main aim of our treatment itself is to maintain the equilibrium of kleda. This is what my concept. And now we will see the therapeutically induced kleda. What could be the therapeutically induced kleda? This is nothing but snehapana. Sneha is also a kleda bhava. Therapeutically increase the, in the case of especially the shodhanaanga snehapana, we are inducing the kleda vritti. We are inducing the kleda vritti. So we can successfully utilize the kleda as a treatment modality also. So this is what first we have to understand, what is kleda, then only the further things the next coming slides can be understood. Next one. Now the initially that I explained that deva bhava. Now that's next, after that I explained this kleda. Now let us go to kala. We should know what is kala also. We know that kala ghallo bhi sapta bhavanti dhatu ashayantara maryada, the one which is situated in between dhatu ashaya. How this kala is being formed, typically explained in the sharira sthana as dhatu ashayantara kledo vibhaktvam swamushmana kleshma snayu apanachanna kalaghya kaatha sarava, is explained in ashtanga hrudaya. At the same time ashtanga sangraha explains little more. यस्तु धात्वाशयान्तरेषु क्लेदा अवतिष्ठते यथा स्वमूष्माभिनिवर्तते स्नायु श्लेष्म जरायुच्छन्न काष्ठयुवसार धातुसार शेषो रसशेषो अल्पत्वा कलासज्ञगा स्नायु श्लेष्म जरायुनाच्छन्न विच इज बीइंग कवर्ड बाय स्नायु आइदर स्नायु और आइदर श्लेष्म और आइदर जरायु by the production of this annual ring or the hardwood from the kashta. Dhadu, like that it is being produced. That is the dhadu sara. Shesho, rasa shesho, alpatva kala satnega. By the quantity, it's a byproduct which is being produced in between the process of dhadu paka. Then we will get another question. If it is similar to dhadu, that's what dhadu saro shesho raso is being explained. It's almost like rasa. Then what is the purpose to differentiate? Why the dhadus and kalas? Why should we differentiate? There is the next line. The next word says that explanation also. Alpatva kalas, the quantity of kala will be comparatively less to dhadu. This is what the difference of this is what the explanation regarding kala. So kala we can consider as a nephrons or the functional unit of kidney. So this is what I feel what is kala. So these are the basic structures what we need to understand the nidana part. Next one.
Sir, in between your voice is breaking, sir. Are you using headphones?
Is it? You want me to repeat from where?
No, sir. Just I think you are using headphone, no, sir. Just adjust a little.
No. I'm directly speaking now.
Sir, yes.
Okay. So I was it clear till now?
Sir, it is clear in between some distortion.
Okay. Maybe. Okay. So the next slide.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
So we see now the last one, that is vrikka. Initially it was drava bhava, then kleda, then kala, and now from kalas what is vrikka? Medha rakta prasadajam medho vahanam srotasam vrikkau moolam. See the relation between dhadus and vrikka. Medho rakta prasadajam is the formation of vrikka. Medho vahanam srotasam vrikkau moolam, vrikka becomes the moola of the medho srotas. So in the ahara jalavahi siradhara, it is being explained by Adhamala in the commentary of Charangadhara Samhita. And The last one is Swedo Vahanam Srodasa Medo Moolam. So one is Meda Rekta Prasadajam, then Medo Vahasrodas, and then Sveda Vahasrodas. These three are the most important factors what we need to know when we go to our therapeutics. Next. Next one. It's already explained. So now let us see the nidanas. We can, as I mentioned earlier, we cannot find a typical specific chapter called chronic kidney disease in any of our samhitas. We have to gather the information from many areas. So for that purpose, just we need to tabulate the various causative factors which can lead to the formation of Vrikka Roga, that is chronic kidney disease. That is, one is definitely that is Dosha Kopa Nidana, which has been explained in the Sarva Roga Nidana. That is Tittoshna Kashaya Alpa, Ruksha Pramita Bhojane, Dharana Udhirana, Nishajagara Atyuccha Bhashane, Kriyadi Yoga, Vishoga, Chinda Vyayama Garshidai. Like that, Dosha Kopa Nidanas are followed. And the next one is Marmaghada, that is typically Charaka Samhita. Chakrapani explained that it is not the Agantuja Marmaghada, but Doshaja Marmaghada plays the important role in the formation of Vrikka Roga. The next one is Vishaja and Krimija. We know there are various chemicals, various causative factors. There are so many modern medicines, even so many Ayurvedic medicines are also which can cause the kidney damages. So such factors also we should take care. And the final last one is Sahaja, that is the acquired or autoimmune. We can consider it as autoimmune. Next one. Yeah. As these functions we know, Mutrasya Kleda Vahanam, Swedasya Kleda Vikriti. Kleda Dharana is the function of Sveda and Kleda Vahana is the function of Mutra. Next one. The transport of Kleda is the function of Mutra. There is a many articles and many classes I have listened once like that. The Kleda is the causative factor for the Vrikka Roga, I mean the chronic kidney disease. But I feel the Kleda is not the actual causative factor. Kleda is the one feature, or Kleda can be considered as a symptom which is produced in the chronic kidney disease. See, what is the reason for the formation of Kleda? The previous slide explained as Mutrasya Kleda Vahanam, the transport of Kleda from body to the, or to the expulsion of Kleda from body is the function of Mutra. So how the Kleda gets larger, or how the quantity of Kleda becomes more in our body, what could be the reason? Definitely, there should be a problem with the transport. There should be a problem with the functioning of Mutra. If the Mutra, the functioning of Mutra is not proper, then only the accumulation of Kleda will be possible in body. So, the basic cause for the chronic kidney disease or whatever it may be, it is not the Kleda. There is one underlying cause for the, there will be an underlying cause for the formation of Kleda that we should identify. And how the Kleda is formed, then only the treatment becomes successful. Otherwise, we will get the result, but the result obtained will be temporary. See, what happened, we'll see. If we are seeing Kleda only, without considering the pathological basis or the proper Nidana for the production of Kleda, if we are not considering, what happened? We give some of the Mutrala Dravyas, some of the Mutra Virajaniya Dravyas, some of the Mutra Virajaniya Dravyas, some of the Mutra Urpadaka Dravyas, and we expel the already formed Kleda from the body. What happens there? The patient gets little bit relief for some time. But the formation, the pathology for the formation of Kleda is still there in his body. So maybe after 3 months, or maybe after 4 months, or maybe after 6 months, he will be prone to such disease again. And the disease will be, there will be a remission of the disease. So we should find out what is the exact cause for the formation of Kleda. then only then we better we have to treat to the exact cause, and along with that we can incorporate the methods to expel the already accumulated cleda. Then only the treatment becomes successful as well as permanent. See, otherwise that could be cannot be we cannot call it as a shuddha chikitsa. There are two types of chikitsa, isn't it? Vishuddha chikitsa and ashuddha chikitsa. Prayoga samayet vyadhim yo anyamanyam udireyet nasau vishuddha shuddhasu samayet yo na kobayet. If it should be a vishuddha chikitsa, we should not induce any other we should not cause any other disease by the treatment of this one. So always look into the samprapti properly, look into the formation of kleda, look into the reason for the formation of kleda. Once that reason is being picked out, then it is very easy to expel the kleda from the body. So this slide becomes, as per my entire core subject in my entire presentation, become because first better you don't focus to the kleda, focus to the underlying pathology of the kleda. Next one. We explaining the nidanas part, we have to find out so many positive factors. There can be pandu, the pandu can be a reason, chobha can be a reason, visarpa can be a reason, vadarakta can be a reason, then what we say urakshada can be a reason, there are even udavarta can be a reason. So we have to find out what is the reason for the formation of kleda. If it is the if the kleda is produced from pandu, see the samprapti of pandu, dhadunam syacha saithilyam ojasascha gunakshayam tena alparakta alpamedasko nissaraswathaneendriya alparakta alpamedas. What is alparakta and alpamedas? What happened when that medas and rakta becomes reduced? Vrikka is being produced from medas and rakta. So because of the pandu, from there can be development of a chronic kidney disease from pandu, from the possible nidanas of pandu. That is vyayama mamlam levanani madhyam mrudam divasupnam adivadeshanam. Such nidanas can lead to reduction in the dhadunam satcha saithilyam tena alparikta alpamedasko nisaraswadhaindriya. That lead in the that is the vyayama mamlam levanani madhyam, such nidanas lead to the formation of pandu, and from that pandu there will be the reduction of quantity of medas and rakta, and from because of that reduction there can be shosha of vrikka. This can be one of the pathology. The treatment becomes different in this. Next one is shobha. See, when the shobha pitta rakta kabhan vayu dushto dushtan bahissira nitva ruddha gadi kurya tokmaamsa samshayam ഉത്സേഹം. So this can be shobha, also can be a reason for the production of the what we say kleda. So the disease the treatment for this kleda produced due to shobha is also different. Next one, the visarpa also can be the same possibility is there with the visarpa also. Next slide. So now let us draw a samprapti. Then only samprapti vikatana is possible. Because of the doshaja nidanas, it may be pandu nidana, it may be vadarakta nidana, it may be urakshada nidana, it may be kshada, what we say udavarta nidana. Because of that nidana, there will be jadharagni mandya. And from jadharagni mandya, we know swasthanastasya kayagne ramso dhadu samsada tesham sadadi deeptibhyam dhadu uddhikshayodhava. From jadharagni mandya there will be dhatukni mandya. From dhatukni mandya there will be dhadu kshaya. From dhadu kshaya, the consecutive dhadu kshaya lead to the kshaya of rakta and medas. Next one. Next slide. Excuse me. Next slide. Am I audible now? Hello? Yeah, before the previous one.
Yes, sir, you're audible, sir.
And the previous one. There are two similar slides with that arrow, the second slide.
Yes, sir. This is the second slide, sir.
Rakta Medakshaya Vata. The 18th slide.
Ah, sir, yes, 18th slide only, sir, it is.
Pardon?
So this is 18th slide, sir, now.
No, this is 19th. I'm seeing now 19th.
17th slide, sir.
Ah, yeah. The next one.
Yes, sir. 18th. Raktamedakshaya
Vata. Ah, yes. It's the same. Yeah. Yes, from Nidanas, Dosha Kopaja Nidanas, that may be Pandu or to Vada Rakta, there will be the Rakta Medha Kshaya. And from because of this Rakta Medha Kshaya, there can be Vada Vrithi, that is Dhadu Kshaya Vada Vrithi. And this Vada Vrithi may lead to Kapha Pitta Vrithi. And because of that excessive production of this Kapha Pitta, quantitative increase of Kapha and Pitta, there will be the accumulation of Kleda. And from Kleda lead to the manifestation of disease. Whatever, maybe the chronic kidney disease, we can name it as chronic kidney disease. This could be the samprapti of a chronic kidney disease. This is as per my perception. From the dosha kopa nidanas, there will be jadaragni mandya. From jadaragni mandya, there will be dhatukni mandya. From dhatukni mandya, there will be dhadu kshaya, especially rekta and medas. That rekta and medha kshaya leads to the vada vruddhi, dhadu kshaya vada vruddhi. Dhadukshaja Vada Vruthi may lead to along with the Kapha Pitta Vruthi also. Because of that Kapha Pitta Vruthi, there will be the, even with the Vada Vruthi also, the, if the functions of Apana Vada is being deranged, that is the function of Mutra, the Shukra Arthava Sagran Mutra Garbha Nishkramana Kriya. If the function of Apana Vada gets deranged, definitely there will be the stagnation of Mutra. And by that, the Kleda Vahana will not be proper. And that leads to accumulation of Kleda. And then the disease is being manifested. This could be the samprapti. Next one. So see the other, there are some relevant other sampraptis also. That is, one is Udavarta samprapti. Udavarta is the very important one because Udavarta is being produced from Vegadharana. Vegadharana is nothing but can lead to, especially the Mutra Vegadharana can lead to Udavarta. Even Sagrud Vega Dharana can lead to Udavarta, and see the indication in the symptoms of Udavarta. Vastavucha Sutaram Shulam Gandesho Yathu Sambhavam is being explained. Vastavucha Sutaram Shulam, severe pain over the Swasti area, as well as Gandesho Yathu Sambhavam, the facial edema or the edema over the jaw area. So we have to see for whether the reason. We have to interrogate the patient for the proper picking up of Nidana. Udara can lead to that. Prameha also can be. Visha also can be lead to. Next. Now we will see the therapeutic. See. So as I explained previously, I explained that reason, the treatment method in each and every chronic kidney disease produced due to different pathology is different. So how to pick up the reason? The treatment in chronic kidney disease produced due to Pandu Nidana is different. The treatment in produced due to Vadarakta Nidana, that is also, see, the Vadarakta Nidana also can lead to kidney. Vidahyannam Virudham Tatta Chastrak Pradushanam. See the Dosha Dushti. The same like that. Shobha, from the Shobha Visarpa Nidanas also can lead to kidney disease. Even Urakshada can also lead to kidney disease. Then the what we say, Vegadharana, we know that Udavarta has explained that Udavarta can also lead to the kidney Vrukkaroga. Even Visha also can lead to Vrikha Roga. You might have confused how this Urakshada lead to what we say kidney disease. Urakshada yutha de sahasai stai sevideira yatha bali. Urasyandakshadevayu pittena anugado bali. Vada and pitta is getting deranged. Don't consider this Urakshada, Yudha, Desa, Stai, Stai, and even the labor work, manual labor workers, the porters, etc., can always lead to the Dhadu Kshaja type of kidney disease, Dhadu Kshaja type of renal problems that can be produced, which is being produced to Urakshada. See the last line of the Urakshada, that is Kshinasya Sasrak Mutratvam, Syacha Prishthakadigraham, Kshinasya Sasrak Mutratvam, Syacha Prishthakadigraham. So these are all the various diseases which can cause with kidney disease. And the treatment also becomes entirely different in all the areas. How that becomes different, that we will see. Next one. So what are the structure, what are the factors we should look forward for what we are treating a kidney patient, a renal disease. First, initially, he should be screened for the Prameha Samprapti. The treatment for the disease produced due to the kidney disease, which is produced or associated with Prameha and without Prameha, is entirely different. We have to see for the associated symptoms. We have to see for the ultrasound changes. Renal parenchymal changes are there. If renal parenchymal changes has been already happened, means it's very difficult to manage. At the same time, we have to see for the renal function test, glomerular filtration rate, as well as the cystatin C. Next one. The general line, as I explained, that is one is the Pajanam, Rukshanam, Snehanam, and finally Rasayanam. This is the general line in the kidney disorders which I follow. And this will be incorporated with the specific treatment for the Nidanas. If the CKD produced due to Pandu, medicines mentioned in the Pandu Chigilsa will be incorporated with this general group. If it is produced due to Vadarakta, the line, the treatment mentioned in the Vadarakta, Vadashonita Chigilsa will be incorporated with this general line. So these are the different the main protocol which we follow, that is Pajanam, Rukshanam, Snehanam, and Rasayanam. How and by which medicines, that we will find out. Next one. Next, the first case. We know that there are five stages of kidney disease, that's CKD, grade 1 to grade 5. So I have tabulated my case as per this case reference. Next. I feel always it's easy to understand if we explain the symptoms of the patient, the symptoms exhibited by the patient, rather than saying something from the textbook. So a male aged 60 came to OPD with some blood reports. Those tests were done as a part of his annual routine checkup. His report revealed that serum creatinine was raised up to 1.69. Other RFT were normal. GFR was 82 ml per minute. On interrogation, revealed the excessive usage of Madhura Rasa, Medho Vardhakahara, and sedentary lifestyle, work style. His urine examination revealed the presence of protein. Proteinuria. He was mildly diabetic since 5 years. He was asymptomatic except the turbid and frothy urine. This is the first case. How we should diagnose this case? How we should manage this case? Next one. These are the report. Serum creatinine was 1.69 and GFR was 82. Next one. Initially, we can diagnose that initial stage of chronic kidney disease, that is grade 1, due to Prameha Nidana. I would consider this as Sandrameha, that is one variety of Kabhaja Prameha. We know that Sandri Bhavet Paryushitam, Sandramehi Pramehadi. The Kabhaja Prameha, one of the Kabhaja Meha, Sandri Bhavet, or maybe or Surameha also. Suramehi Suraturilyam Ubaryacham Athokhanam. So the better correlation will be in this condition. I feel that is Sandrameha, that is Sandri Bhavet Paryushitam, Sandramehi Paryushitam, the turbid urine, Sandramehi Pramehati. So more I would like to consider this as Sandrameha, and this is produced due to the accumulation of Kleda. So the reason for the accumulation of Kleda is nothing but Prameha. And so I would diagnose this case as chronic kidney disease grade 1 due to Prameha Nidana. Next one. How to manage this? The drug of choice. The properties of the drug of choice should be, I would like to consider this, the drugs should be Pachana, Kleda Shoshana, at the same time Mutra Pravartaka also. I would consider this asanadigana, asanati nisha pushta shweta vaha prahiriya, which starts from that. And that could be my drug of choice. And pandurogam prameham cha medo dosha nivarhana becomes the indication of asanadigana. So pandurogam prameham cha medo dosha nivarhana. The disease is chronic CKD produced due to prameha nidana, either asanadigana or aragudhadigana. Aragudhadi also. And the next one, I would consider this Musali Gadiradi or Punanavashtaka Kvata. And the same time, the another one is Ayaskriti. This would be my drug of choice. How this should be differentiated, that will explain later. So either Asanadigana, Aragudhadigana. That's what I explained. The properties should be Prameha Samana, at the same time Kleda Shoshana, at the same time Pachana. Musali Gadiradi is the one which is being explained in Pradara. Pradara also is another disease which is produced due to the accumulation of Kleda. So, and see, when we see the ingredients, Musali Gadira, Trigandaga, Amalaga, Jambu, Vari, all these drugs have got Pramehara properties also, as well as Kleda Shoshana properties also. So, either Musali Gadiradi or Punarnavashtaga or Ayaskriti. Ayaskriti, which contains again Asanadigana as well as Valsagadigana. Valsagadigana has got a specific indication, that is Chala Kapha. The Kapha, with the only one Gana which has a specific, typical indication, that is Chala Kapha, which is nothing but the moving Kleda. This is what I consider. Next one. Next. The another case. A female aged 65 came to OPD with excessive tiredness, palpitation and occasional bilateral pedal edema since 3 months. On examination, her creatinine was raised to 2.5 and blood urea was 35. On interrogation, excessive usage of amla lavanarasa, day sleep and non-nutritious food has been revealed. On further evaluation, GFR found to be 70. USG could not reveal anything significant. Next. These are the reports. Blood urea was 35, serum creatinine was 2.5. And only the ADPKD, that is what we say, polycystic kidney disease. That is okay. Even anyone can happen that polycystic kidney, and that is less harmful also. Next one. So my diagnosis would be chronic kidney disease grade 2 produced due to panduroga nidana. That is vidahyam amla lavanarasa. Vidahyamlam viruddham cha tattacha vyayamam amlam lavanani madhyam. Mrdam divasupnam adivadishnam. Nishevyamanasya vidushya rektam. Doshastvajam panduradam niyandi. So, I would consider this case as a chronic kidney disease which is being produced due to panduroga nidana. The treatment is entirely different from the previous one. How we can find out? We'll see. Next. The drug of choice should possess Pajana, Kleda Shoshana, as well as Mutra Virajaniya. My choice will be again Punarnavashtaka. There is one special kvatha called Ardhavilva in Sahasra Yoga or Sukumara Kvatha. Even Shadharanam can be another choice. Ayaskriti or Kaudaja Tribhala. Both these medicines have got indication in Pandu also. Asanadigana is also an indication because Kapham Kandun Prameham Cha Medo Doshani Parhana. So we have to incorporate the Panduroga Chikilsa along with the what we say Vrukka Roga Chikilsa. Next one. Yes, yeah. A female aged 60 came to OPD with excessive tiredness, palpitation, polyarthralgia, erythema on small joints and consistent bilateral pedal edema since 2 years. On examination, her creatinine was 4.5, urea was 70, RA factor was 25, and ANA was also positive. On further evaluation, GFR found to be 28 ml. USG also could not reveal anything significant. What could be the diagnosis? Next. These are the reports. I would diagnose as chronic kidney disease, grade 3, produced due to vadashonitha nidana, because the associated symptoms reveals the presence of vadashonitha. So the reason could be the vada, the vidahi amlam viruddham cha tatta chastrak pradushanam bhajadam vidhinam cha swapna jagaram aithunam prayena sukumaranam achankramana shilinam abhikhadata shuddhesha nrinam asriji dushite vadalayar shidalayar vayu vruddha vruddho vimargaka. This could be the pathology in this case. So I would diagnose this case as a chronic kidney disease, grade 3, produced due to vadashonitha nidana, and the treatment becomes entirely different from the previous two cases. Next. Here, I would go for Shatavari Chinaruhadi or Pajanamrdam Kashayam. Both these medicines are being explained in the Ama Pajana, in the Jwara, as well as Vadarakta condition. And my drug of choice, the another drug of choice will be Sudarshanam and Shadharanam. Vaidharana Vasti initially followed by Kshira Vasti would be my choice. So the Sudarshanam and Shadharanam are both are Amapajana. But definitely there has got a difference in the indications. Sudarshanam is Tiktarasa Pradhana, Pajanamrdam is Tiktarasa Pradhana, and Shadharanam is Kadurasa Pradhana. We can do this Pajana with Tiktarasa and we can do this Pajana with Kadurasa. If we find out the symptoms in the Sama Pitta, the best option will be Tiktarasa, the Pajana with Tiktarasa. If it is Sama Kapha, the best option will be the Pajana with Kadurasa. The Kadurasa Pajana Dravyas are Shadharanam, Panjakolam, etc. And Tiktarasa Pajana Dravyas, I would consider this Pajanamrdam, Shadangam, and Sudarshanam, etc. How we will identify this, what we say, Pitta and Kapha, whether it is Sama Pitta and Sama Kapha, that I will explain later. Next. Case 4. Male age, who was a retired loco pilot in train, came to OPD with excessive tiredness, palpitation, and consistent bilateral pedal edema. Pain on lower abdomen, constipation, and abdominal distension since 2 years. On examination, his serum creatinine was 6.5, urea was 70. GFR found to be 20 ml per minute. USG, next one. USG revealed the grade 1 parenchymal changes. Mild bilateral pleural effusion, hepatomegaly, grade 1 parenchymal changes. Next one. Yeah. What could be the diagnosis? As I mean explained previously, I would consider this the Vega Dharana as the main reason for the production of, for the development of this type of, in the chronic kidney disease in this condition, in this patient. So I would diagnose as chronic kidney disease grade 4 produced due to Vega Dharana or Udavarta. Udavarta is the one which is produced due to Vega Dharana, especially this Mutra Vega Dharana or Shabrud Vega Dharana. Mutra Adhovada even can be consider even Adhovadas also. Mutra, the next one, Shagrud Vegarotha also can be a reason in case of what we say in this condition, because being his job, he may not be able to pass urine as well as bowel, etc., in the proper time because of the improper duty schedule. The drug of choice initially, Pachanam, Kledashoshanam, may not be sufficient because of the structural damage. In this condition, as being this grade 4, already there the structural damage has been occurred. So in such cases, the structural damage or shosha indicates the involvement of vata. Once the clay, the shoshana is obtained, as the first phase has been obtained, then we have to go for snehanam. Especially avabhidaka snehapanam is the best drug of choice, best method of choice in this condition. And I would consider this the drug of choice as either sukumaram or dadimadigrada or tiktaka grada or indukanta grada. Next one. Avabhedaka Snehavana. How to do this Avabhedaka Snehavana? Where is this mentioning of Avabhedaka Snehavana is meant? Explain. Avabhedaka Snehavana is the first reference of Avabhedaka Snehavana we get from the Roganulpadaniya chapter, isn't it? Mutrajeshu Tupani Pranthattam Sasyadegridam Jirnandigam Chuktamaya Matraya Yojana Dvayam Avabhedaka Medaccha Sapnidam. Especially the burst modality in the disease produced due to Mutravega Dharana. How the Avabhedaka has to be done? What does the meaning? What this? What is the previous one? The what could be the significance of this picture? The sandwich. Avabhedaka is nothing but it's a type of sandwich. See, annam avabhedayati. That's what Avabhedaka. The medicines. The what are the aushadha kalas for Avabhedaka? Avabhedaka snehavana is whether is it shodhananga snehavana or samana snehavana. Avabhedaka is not a shodhananga snehavana. Avabhedaka is definitely it's a samana. And the aushadha kala is two. Two times you have to give in a day in Avabhedaka. That is, one is pragbhaktam. Mutrajeshu tu pani pragbhaktam uttamaya matraya yojana dvayam jirnandigam. That is, the drugs should be, the quantity of the should be, the ghee should be decided previously. And that should be given in divided dose. The half portion can be divided as pragbhaktam. And the remaining portion can be given after the digestion of the food. That is jirnandigam. The pragbhaktam, just before the food intake. And the half portion should be taken just before the food intake. That is, if you are giving in the 50 ml as an initial dose, 25 ml you can give in the early morning, maybe around 8:30. And you can ask him to take his breakfast at 9 a.m. And then the remaining 25 ml should be given only after the breakfast has been digested. So this is the method of doing Avabhedaka. So the food, the breakfast he has taken is getting compressed in between the two doses of the Ghrita. That's what Avabhedaka. Annam Avabhedayadi Yattat Avabhedakam. So that's the, it's a typical type of sandwich. This is what Mutrajeshu Tu Pane Pragbhaktam Sasyade Ghritam Jirnandigam Cha Uttamaya Matraya Yojana Dvayam Avabhedakam Edaccha Sapnidam. Next. So the drugs can be either Sukumara Ghritam or Dadimadi Ghritam. If you have got an association with Kapha, you can select Dadimadi Ghritam. If there is the Shobha condition is more, then you can opt for Sukumara Ghrita. If severe Agni Mandya is there, better in case severe Agni Mandya, if at all you have better to avoid the Ghrita Pana, if at all you have to do the Ghrita Pana, better option will be what we say Indugandha Ghrita. And if you suspect the association of Pitta, you can either go for Tiktaka and or Kalyanaka Ghrita. How to identify whether the patient can or the patient is suitable for Gradapana or not. For that purpose, we have to take the reference from Jwara Jigilsa, or that is Kashaya Pana Patyana Dashahiriti Lingita Sapirdadya Kaphe Mande Vadapitotare Jure. These should be the criteria for selection of whether he is able to, whether he is suitable for Gradapana or not. Sarpirdadya kabhe mande, his kabha level should be reduced. And vada pitotare jure, whether in, by the increase of vada and pitta. If he fulfills this criteria, that is, kashaya pana pathyana dashahe ridilinkhida, sarpirdadya kabhe mande, vada pitotare jure. If he fulfills this criteria, you can go for the gridapana, especially with the Avabhedaka Snehapana. The last case, male 60 years. Came to OPD with complaints of severe bilateral pedal edema, pruritus all over body, severe lethargy, reduced renal output, and severe anemia. His creatinine was about 10. GFR was 15 per minute, increased urine protein, severe parenchymal changes in USP. Next one. You can see the level. The serum creatinine was 10.5. And the other features of bilateral renal disease, complete renal disease. And you can see the spot urine was 300 something, where the normal range comes around 35. So this is the next slide. this become yeah the previous one. Okay, only one. So this becomes the grade 5 chronic kidney disease, which is produced due to the typical renal cause itself without any other causative factor or without any other unidentifiable causative factors. Next. So I don't have much experience in this managing this type of condition. Only 2 or 3 cases I have handled as palliative, and the principle was the Pajana and Clay the Shoshanam, especially the Kshaaravasthi, that is Vaidharanavasthi, was the best one in reducing creatinine or the renal functions in this case. Vaidharanavasthi, we know, is explained in the Amavada Adhikara, that is Palam Shukti Karshakudave Ramli Guda Sindhu Janma Gomutre Karshanyudo Vastiriyam Vaidharana Kshaaravasthi Prasasyate, is the Rukshavasthi, which has been explained in the Amavada condition. At the same time, Manjishtadi Kshaaravasthi also. Or if that much ama or kleda is not that much produced, that much is not there, then you can go for Dvanjamooladivasthi or Rajayapanavasthi. Next. So these are the factors which we should take care in dealing with the chronic kidney disease. One, we should be able to assess the status of his acne properly. Presence of ama, we can identify it, definitely the presence of ama, whether ama is present or not. But as I mentioned earlier, simply identifying the presence of ama is not sufficient. We should be able to identify whether it is sama vata, whether it is sama pitta, and whether it is sama kapha. Definitely, we know that the treatment of ama is nothing but pajanam. But that pajanam itself varies in all these conditions, in sama vatam, sama pittam, and sama kapham. How do we identify whether it is sama vata, sama pitta, and sama kapha? There is a reference which is being explained in Ashtanga Hridayam, the Moola Grantham. It's not there in the I don't know the commentary, but still the Doshadivijnaniya chapter, sorry, Dvidhobhakramaniya chapter, regarding when he explains the ama context, in the there is one small underlined version. It's there in the normal the text. In that chapter you can find out one reference called as sama vada lakshanam, sama pitta lakshanam, sama kapha lakshanam, which are there. I will just explain that. Vayu samo vibandho tandra andra gojane vedana shobha nistode kramasho angani pedaye. The next line is very important. Sneha dir vruddhi mayadi surya meghodaye nishi. If the pain or his complaints getting increased by the application of sneha, sneha devruddhi mayadi, at the time of suryodaya, surya meghodaye nisi, at the time of varshakala, at the time of ratri, if the patient has more complaints, more severe in these times, better to consider it as samavada. And how to identify this samapitta? Amlika rukkantha dahagaram pittam samam minirdise. If the patient explains the conditions like amlika, that is belching, or sore throat, kantha hridaham, burning sensation in the stomach, etc., amlika kantha hridahagaram samam pittam minadise, and how to identify samakapha, avilas tandulasthyanam kantha deshe avadishthade. If you ask to the patient, if you interrogate the patient, definitely he say that he feels something has been blocked inside his throat, kantha deshe avadishthade. He may not be able to explain that, but we can see that he is doing like like this. Always he will be doing like this to clear out his respiratory passage. That indicates the typical feature of samakapha. The treatment becomes different in all these conditions. Samapitta and samavada, the better option is tiktarasa pajana, that is with either pajanamrdam kashayam or shadangam kashayam or sudarshanam. Sudarshan Churna or Sudarshan Gutika or Mahasudarshan Vatti or whatever it may be. In case of Samakapha, always it's better to do with Kadu Rasa. That is, either we can be do Panchakola or Shadharana. If you are administering the Kadu Rasa Drivya, especially the Shadharana Churna or Panchakola Churna, in a Samapitta condition, definitely there will be a flare up of condition. So always be careful in dealing with this type of conditions. Only the diagnosing the presence of ama is not only sufficient in the management of such serious diseases. You should be able to identify whether it is sama vata, sama pitta, and sama kapha. Then we have to look for the presence of avarna. We have to look for the presence of kleda. And the slide, please. Excuse me. Excuse the slide has. Am I audible now? Hello. 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 Hello,
sir.
Okay.
Hello, sir.
What happened? Slide has closed, I think.
A connection issue from our side, sir. We will just share the screen.
Okay. Sure.
Sir, is your screen visible, sir?
For me, yeah, definitely. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Sir, yes. Sorry for the interruption, sir.
Definitely, no problem. So, the presence of kleda, we should be able to identify the presence of kleda. We should be able to identify the presence of other upadravas. Next one. It's not moving. Excuse me. Hello. Yeah. Next slide. Next one. Okay. So now we will see how to differentiate the different aushadha yogas which can be used in the conditions, in this type of conditions. We know there are different kinds of medicine. There are swathas, there are churnas, there are arishta, grita yogas are there. But each and every yogas has got their own specialities and peculiarities. If we identify or if we differentiate them in what we say in the minute, if we go to in the minute details, then only we can shoot the medicines precisely. So for that purpose, let us compare this. These are the main set of medicines which I use in my practice. That is, one is Pachanamrita, the Punarnavartaka, Sukumara, Arthavilva, and Drakshati. Now let's compare the properties of all these, the parameters. So the Pachanamrita Kashaya, the reference is in Chikitsa Manjari, which is a Malayalam textbook. There and the main ingredients are Amrita, Ushira, Villu Abdha, and Parpadaka. The indication is nothing, the Jwara for this Pajana purpose. It can be given as Toya Paga also, Toya also. So it is Pajana and especially indicated in Sama Pitta, as I explained. Is Tikta Pajana and Kleda Shoshana. At the same time, Punarnavashtaka Kvatam, the ingredients are Punarnava, Nimba, Padola Shundi, Tikta Amrita Darvi, Abhaya Kashaya, Sarvanga Shobhodara Gulma Sulam, Shwasanyutam, Pandugadam Nihandi. So the Pajana and Shobhara is more Shobhara than Pajana Amrita. At the same time, the Pajana property is comparatively less in comparing to Pajana Amrita. This is more indicated in Samakapha, is Kadu Pajanam and Kleda Shoshanam. Then Ardhavillum, only very small, limited medicines are there. Nagara, Brihadi, Duralabha, and Punarnava. In this condition, the Punarnava becomes the double quantity. So the entire quantity, that is Nagara, the total quantity of Nagara, Brihadi, Duralabha, and equal to Punarnava. It is comparatively more Shobharam than what we say Punarnavashtaka Kvatha. Less Pajana, more Shobhara. This is also Kadu Tikta Rasa Pradhana, Ushna Virya. And Sukumaram. In the Punarnava, again, the Punarnava becomes the main ingredient. There is Dashamulam also, Ashwagandha and Shatavari. This is also a Shobhara drugs and more indicated in Samavada condition. This Shobharam as well as Shulaharam and Kleda Shoshanam. And then comes the Drakshadi. That is Draksha Madhuga Madhugam, Lothra Kashmirya Shariba, Mranala Chandanoshira, Patma Kesara Patmagam. The indication is in Jwara itself. It is Jwaraharam and Klamaharam. It is nourishing in nature and it's little bit Brahmanam. Shobharatva is less comparing to the other medicines. But at the same time, it is more nourishing. Because of that purpose, this Drakshadi would be the best choice in conditions like albuminuria, microalbuminuria and proteinuria, etc. Because Drakshadi is little bit Stambhana also. So in the conditions like associated with the proteinuria, albuminuria, etc., the best, as per my perception, the best option is Drakshadi. And the Pajanamrutam is more Pajana. Punarnava Ashtaga is comparatively less Pajana to Pajanamrutam. Ardhavillum is comparatively more Shobharam than Punarnava. Sukumaram is what we say Vadanulovanam and Shobharam, and Drakshadi is Stambhanam and Klamaharam. This can be, we can differentiate the different yogas which we use in the treatment like this. Next one. Next, yeah. Practically, this medicine, Pajanamrutam, we can start the treatment. Pajanamrutam is the best medicine to start the treatment as an initial phase for getting proper Pajana in Sama Pitta condition. For severe Agni, or the conditions with severe Agni Mandya, less Shobha. You can use this Pajanamrutam. And then Punarnavashtavam, as a second phase, we can prescribe after the initial Pajana process. It is more Shobhara and less what we say Pajana. In case of Ardhavillum, it is you can prescribe in severe Shobha and Agni if this Agni is little bit proper. Sukumaram, in case of Vigunagadi of Vada, especially. Sukumaram is the best option in the disease, which if it is produced, if we suspect the disease is produced due to Vegadharana or Udavarta, the best option will be Sukumaram. Drakshadi, as I explained, more effective in last phase or highly beneficial in condition with the protein and albumin loss. Next. Regarding the Ghrida, Indugandham, Vada or Vada Kapha Prasamana. We know that Udiga Daru, Dashamula Garanta Shaya Siddham, Takshira Shatpalayutam, Ghridam Indugandham, Vada Amaya Kshaya Mahodara Gulma Shulam, Nimno Nada Jaraharam Balavarthanamcha. Vada Amaya Kshaya Maho, even though it is indicated in Vada Vyadi, it contains Panjagolam, etc. So better not to give in Dhadu Kshaya Vada Vyadi, better to use in the Avarana Jinni Vada Vyadi. If he suffer from Agni Madhya, the best option will be Indugandham. Tiktagam, as I explained in the previous stage, it's Pitta predominant conditions, if it is associated with less Kleta and Shobha. Mahadiktam is the difference from Tiktagam and Mahadiktam. Mahadiktam contains, the Mahadiktam is being processed with Amalagi Swarasa, and thereby that becomes more Rasayana in comparison with the Tiktagam. That is the difference between Tiktaga is more Shamana and Mahadikta is more Rasayana. then Kalyanagam and Mahakalyanagam. In case of association with Visha, if we suspect the disease is produced due to any of the chemical induced or iatrogenic or medicine induced, we can opt the best medicine as Kalyanagam or Mahakalyanagam. In Sukumaram, especially Vigunavada and severe Shova, if the disease is produced due to Udavartha Nidana, we can opt Sukumara, because Sukumara Grada contains Buddha as well as air and daila. So both are indicated in the Vigunavada. Dadimadi, if it is indication is Pandu, and if the disease is produced due to Pandu Roga Nidana, we can opt this Dadimadi as a disease, best option. Next one. And some other the therapeutics we have to as this is a serious disease, especially the marma asrada vyadhi, the simple medicines may not be sufficient in such cases. So we have to go for some more drug delivery method, new drug delivery method. That is, his pana and his anna should be processed with the medicine. Initial stages, if it is pit, if he is suffering, if we consider it as a sama pitta, we can process the anna with or yavagu with shadanga or pajanamrita kvatha, and then you can prepare the shadanga yavagu, shadanga siddha yavagu or pajanamrita siddha yavagu. And if severe agnimandya and kapha predominant conditions, you can process the anna with panchakola. In case of severe shobha, we can process the yavagu with dashamula. We can change the diet also like this. Then if we suspect, as I explained, any type of chemical induced or iatrogenic, we have got another option in vishajigilsa, especially in the Ashtangarde, vishajigilsa is explained, that is koshadakyadi peya. Koshadakya atnika patha surya valli amrita abhaya shenu shirisha kinehi asarva vishapaha. And this is a peya which is mean explained in case of visha, in the preparation of peya in all the visha. So this in place of Chadanga or Panchakola, we can replace Koshadakyadi in case of iatrogenic diseases. And there is one Aviltoladi Bhasmam. Aviltol is nothing but Chiruvilla, and the Chiru, it's a type of Chara. You can process this Bhasma, you can dilute this Bhasma by boiling in water, and that water can be used as preparation of Peya or Yavagu. The same procedure can be used with Palashakshara also. Next. And there is one another modality, that is Gudardhaka Prayogam, which is explained in the Shobha Jigilsa. That is Tulyam Gudam Nagaram Cha Pragunjardha Vivartitam. Equal quantity of Buddha and Nagara have been ground together and given in Vardhamana Prayoga. Like Vardhamana, what we give in Vardhamana people, Pragunjardha Vivardhitam, every day that half Pragunja should be increased. Gudardhaka Prayoga is very best medicine in case of Shobha Jigilsa, especially the kidney disease, especially with the predominance of Shobha. Then Vaidharanavasti, that is Palam Sukti Karshakurave, Amli Gudasindhu Janma Gomutre, Karshanido Vastiriyam, Vaidharana, Sharavasti Prasasade, which has been explained in the Amavada Adhikara. Then another one is Manjishtadik Sharavasti, Divanjamuladivasti, are the other options in this type of condition. Next. So, we will see how much improvement we can give in such a cases. If we grade the symptoms of the patient, if he comes to us with the pedal edema with a grading of 4 to 5, within 3 months or 4 months treatment, we can reduce to 1 to 2. Lethargy, we can reduce to 1 to 2. Pruritus, we can reduce to almost nil. We can completely, we can stop it completely. Facial edema also, we will be able to reduce almost in the normalcy. GAT symptoms also, we can reduce completely. And finally, the overall symptoms, if it is being graded as 4 to 5, we can reduce to 1 to 2. Next one. So now we will see a standard operating procedure. As I am a person from Vaishajagalpana or R&B, our main area is preparation of SOP. For each and every process, we need an SOP. We need some flow chart to follow. So how we can make a flow chart in case of renal disease, we'll see. Next. if a patient comes to you with a pedal edema, initially the initial step should be blood. The suspect, if you suspect something, some kidney involvement, initial step should be the blood, nothing but blood evaluation. Once that blood evaluation, if we find out some creatinine level, increase the creatinine level, then next stage is we have to find out whether it is he is associated with the DM or with the DM or without DM. Whatever it may be, he may be with DM or without DM, we have to analyze for the presence of Samavada, Samapitta and Samakapha. And then we have to find out the apt medicine for this pajana in case of if it is Samavada, if it is Samapitta, if it is Samakapha. Once the pajana stage has been over, if the ama nirharana is happened completely, then the next stage is kleda shoshana. And once the kleda has been removed completely, then last stage is for to prevent the what with the punaravartaka, that is rasayana. This can be the standard operating procedure followed in the case of renal disease. Next. Still, whatever may be, this much modalities I have explained, but still there is a quotation in Ashtanga Hridayam, especially in the Vadashonita Chikilsa, that is, Mede Majjasthigagada, Ede Sthanasya Gambhirya, Siddhiye Yur Yatnato Nava, Tasmat Jayet Navanetan, Velino Nirupadravan. As the disease is produced that due to Meda, Majja and Asthi, etc., deeper dhadus, Ede Sthanasya Gambhirya, because of the importance of the sthana, it's very difficult. Siddhiye Yur Yatnato Nava, it will be very difficult to manage. It may be able to manage, but there are many possibilities for for not getting the result also. Tasmat, for that, Jayet Navan Edan Varino Nirupadirvan, always we should start the treatment in the Nava Avastha before developing the Upadrava condition. Next. This is what I would like to quote in as a last step, that is, Yat Chinatyama Matnyana, Yascha Pakkum Upekshita, Supachaviva Vitneyo Tava Nishchita Karano. This is also a quotation from Ashtanga Hridaya, Shalyaharana Vithi. Ajarya explained the importance of stage-wise treatment. What treatment should be given in each and every stage? We are supposed to do that, but only. We should do the Ama Pajana in the Ama Avastha only. If you are doing this Ama Pajana, once that Ama Avastha is finished, again, that becomes a burst. Or we are not supposed to start Brahmana in case of Ama Avastha. So we have to assess the condition of the patient thoroughly, and then only we should start the treatment. This is what he explained. If we are missing, or if we are being confused because of the ajnana, we are supposed to consider as chandala. That is what shopaja aviva vitneyo, those who we should be compared with the person who eat what we say shwa, that is dog, that is chandala. So yat chinatyamam ajnana yatcha pakkum upekshite shopaja aviva vitneyo tava nischita karanam. Next. So once again, I'm expressing my sincere gratitude to the organizers, especially the Dr. Sriganesh, and then the Pooja, Dr. Pooja and Dr. Anu, and finally, and the great gratitude to Dr. Madhav Digavi sir. He found time to call me in the morning, and I never expect his call, such a great call from such a great person. And once again, thank you for giving me an opportunity. Thank you. I think if you have got any doubts, I will try to clear myself. And if it is beyond my knowledge, I will refer it and I will get back to you. Once again, thank you.
Thank you, sir, for such a clear and enlightening session, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, there is one question in the chat box. From Dr. Nazar. Good evening, sir. Mode of action of Shirabasti, and at what stage of CKD we can give Vaitaranabasti followed by Shirabasti?
Yeah, Vaitaranabasti should be given, and if the disease is produced due to Vadarishonita Nidana, as I explained. If we suspect the disease is produced due to वादशम दट इज विदाह्यन्नम विरुद्धम च तत्तच्चास्त्र प्रदूषणम भजतां विधिहीनम च इफ द निदान आर वादशोन द निदान इनिशियल एंड आल्सो इफ इट ही इज असोसिएटेड विद सामा कंडीशंस बेटर यू गो फॉर वैदर्णवस्ति in initially and because by doing this vairanavasti his ama avastha will be relieved and then to improve after vairanavasti there will be some rukshatva in his koshta to prevent that rukshatva the next stage is kshiravasti that is being the kshiravasti is also indicated in vadashonida itself that kshiradu prasadau karyam madhu taila kritha sama it's been explained that is in the vadashonita chikitsa itself so initially in the ama avastha that disease the ckd produced or ckd associated with the rheumatic complaints you can opt vairanavasti as an initial and once the ama nirharana happen then go for the kshiravasti that's the protocol which I follow
thank you sir I hope the doubt is clear there is another doubt in the comment box sir from Dr. Maitre how can we understand kleda in modern science sir
yeah modern science whatever it may be whatever the drava bhavas in the body that's what lesiga shabdam acharya clearly explained tattu vranagadam toggadam vranagadam lesiga shabdam lesiga shabda vachyam lesiga is one among the kleda then that is the plasma is can be considered as the kleda then what we say the sweat can be considered as a part of kleda then what we the metabolic waste that is creatinine urea etc can be considered as the kleda whatever the things which are being expelled through sweat as well as urine we can consider it's a part as kleda that's because that's what the function of mutrasya kleda vahanam so all that metabolic waste which is being transported through urine route I consider as a kleda the drava bhava kleda
thank you sir Dr. Pavitra again she extended her question sir can you explain how kushta leads to ckd
kushta both kushta as well as krimi both are kleda pradhana and kushta leads to kleda and krimi originates from this kleda this is the sequence prabadya dhadun vyapyandya sarvan samkledya chavahe is the end of explanation from in the kushta nirasyade tadvat kushnaadi tad kushnaadi tadvapu because of what are the nidanas of kushta that is mithyahara viharena visheshena virodhina साधु निंदा वध अन्यस्तु हरणाद्येश्च पीडिते पापमभि कर्मभि सद्य प्राक्तेनेर्वेरिदोमला सी द अनदर लाइन इज द संप्राप्ति प्राक्तेने द पूर्व जन्म पाप प्राक्तेन ईरिदोमला द और द अदर निदान पॉजिटिव फैक्टर्स द ईरिदोमला द दोषास आर गेटिंग विशिएटेड प्राक्तेनेर्वेरिदोमला सिरा प्रबद्य तिर्यग तुक लसिगा अस्रगामिषम एंड दैट व्हाट वी से what moves to the siras sira prabadya tiryaga especially the tiryaga siras to lesiga asrik amisham that vitiates the to lesiga asrik and amisha mamsa these are the initial the factors which are being vitiated then sarva kleda medo vasa madhya sagar mutro vashoshana then that leads to the kleda meda etc so once this asrit and medas are being involved definitely there will be the association with vrikka because vrikka is also originated from the rakta and meda prasadaja later the kleda will be increased in the body from that kleda there can be the generation of krimi okay
thank you sir in our hospital sir for if there is creatinine more than 8 and if urea is around 200 or more than 200 we prefer antrabasti sir aja antrabasti we give and after two to three courses every 15 day we follow one course so afterwards the creat has come to 5 sir and urea has come to 89 so sir can you share your experience on antrabasti what may be the mechanism
actually I'm not familiar with that procedure and anyway I will it's a new information for me also so I also need to collect more details and I will get back to you anyway. I'm not aware of that.
Okay. Procedure. Thank you, sir.
First time, to be frank, to be this is first time I'm hearing such a great procedure.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there is another question from Bhargav. Namaste, sir. Can a patient undergo dialysis? Okay, can a patient under dialysis be treated for Mukha Shofa?
Yeah, definitely we can do. Eganga, that can be treated with the egg, that line with the Eganga Shobha. Eganga Shobhe Varshabhu. Varshabhu becomes the, or Punarnava becomes the main drug of choice in such Eganga Shobha. If it is in Sarvanga Shobha, there are some other medicines. So always better, you can, even if he is dialysis also, you can start with Punarnavata Kvatha or Arthavilla or Sukumara. Definitely there is no problem, but the only one thing you should be particular regarding the, what we say, the fluid intake. See, the Punarnava or other, the Punarnava, the one thing is, there is a misconception regarding Punarnava. We consider this Punarnava is a Mutrala Dravya. But I have referred in most of the Nikandus, but never I couldn't find out a reference that is Punarnava as Mutrala. Punarnava is Shoshana, Kleda Shoshana. So we are not supposed to give any of the Mutrala Dravyas when he is doing this under, when he is under dialysis. But this a type of Shoshana or Pajana can be done with when even in case so if he is under dialysis also. So that can be possible with this Punarnava itself. Punarnava is a Pajana, it's not a Mutrala.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there is another question from Vaidya Raghav. He is asking how to bring normal levels of serum creatinine, like you explained yogas in albuminuria and proteinuria.
How to bring normal levels of serum creatinine, like you explained in yogas. Serum creatinine. Through the pajana only. Clay the pajana and clay the shoshana. The same method will be sufficient. And anyway, what my opinion is, better don't focus the creatine. Creatines are the diagnostic parts. Just we can see through, we have to analyze through our own terms and conditions. Creatines, creatine or urea, etc., are the alarming signs. They are the indicators of the prognosis. So our aim should not be to reduce the creatine level. Once we should treat the disease. Once we attain that process, once we are becoming success in treating the normal actual pathology, automatically the creatinine also will be coming down. Definitely it comes down. Once the kidney functions gets improved, the creatinine will be and urea will be improved. And simply by as per my observation, there is no such medicines to reduce the simple creatinine or urea. Well, you have to improve the renal function through the modality which I was explaining, that is Pajanam and play the social.
Thank you, sir. There are no other questions in the chat box, sir. So thank you so much, sir. Thank you for being with us. Now I request Dr. Madhav Diggavi, sir, to present vote of thanks.
Namaste, sir. It was a fantastic session.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
A lot of practical-oriented, clinical-oriented, practice-oriented stimulation is given by you, sir. Most of the audience are very happy and there is a good feedback there.
Thank you, sir.
Initially, you made a statement that if you understand CKD in detail, it is very easy to handle the case.
Yes, sir.
And you have proved it at the end of 1 hour 38 minutes, where you have taken a lot of efforts and you have outspoken and clearly explained avastika chikitsa and bheshaja samyojana vijnanam. It is useful for academic purpose as well as practice purpose. So we are happy to say acknowledgement and a vote of thanks to you, sir, on behalf of our PG department as well as Tarnath Government Ayurvedic Medical College and our beloved principal, Dr. Syed Atta Fatima.
Very nice to meet you, sir. It's really a pleasure to meet you, sir.
We may trouble you again and again to invite you for our different webinar themes.
Definitely, sir. Definitely, anytime, sir.
It is also one of the tribute to our beloved Dr. Late G. Srinivas Acharya, sir.
Yes, sir. That's what I explained, sir. He is he made the eye opening for me in treating this renal disease, really.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you once again. Shubhratri.
Shubhratri.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
So, shall we end this session, sir, now?
Yeah, definitely. Shall I take leave?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.